Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about factoring today, the very beginning of factoring, which is taking out the greatest common factor. And before I go through the little definitions I have up there, I just want to show you the five examples or the five problems that I'm going to work out for you today. So if you can see ahead of time if there's something that you'd like to actually see on this video. When we say we're factoring out the greatest common factor, we need to find the greatest common factor of the terms, and then we divide each term by the greatest common factor. When we state the answer, the greatest common factor that you found in step one is in front of the parentheses, while the answer from dividing each term is inside the parentheses. And you can always check your answer by multiplying. So let's look at the first couple of examples that I have listed there. Get a little too much light and see if that helps. Okay, so what's the common factor for 5x minus 15? Well, they each have a 5 in them. So the greatest common factor is going to be 5. So I'm going to divide, I'm going to put my 5, that's going to go outside my parentheses. And then inside the parentheses is what I get when I divide. So I'm going to divide each term by 5 because that was the GFC. GCF. All right, 5 over 5 cancels, that leaves x. 15 divided by 5 is 3, so the answer is 5 times x minus 3. Now, why would you ever want to factor? Well, once you have it in factored form, you can do things with it, especially simplify fractions, that kind of thing. So it's a process that we use to be able to do other things. All right, so I can always check by multiplying. 5 times x is 5x. 5 times 3 is 15. The sign matters, but you can see I kept the minus sign there. Okay, number 2, a little bit more difficult. What's the common factor for this one? Well, you can see that between 4, 8, and 2, the common factor for that would be 2. The greatest common factor. You always want to take out the biggest one. So I know that I have it 2. And then I have variables. And when I have variables, I want to take the variables out as well. And so the question is, how many y's can I take out of here? Well, this only has one y. So what they have in common is they at least have one y in there. Other ones have more, but all I can take out is the one that they all have in common. So I'm going to have 2y outside my parentheses. Now I'm going to divide everything by 2y. And that part, I always write it down so I can see it, but if you do it in your head, that's fine. 4 over 2 is 2. And now you say, okay, I've got y's. I've got 3 on top and 1 on the bottom. That looks like this, right? So when you think about the rules for exponents, you just subtract. 3 minus 1 is 2 because one of those would be canceled and 2 would be left. Here I have a minus. I want to be true to my signs. I have 8 divided by 2, which is 4. And then I have one additional y on the top, so I get 4y. And here's the one that I wanted to be careful with you, is that when you have something divided by itself, sometimes people say, oh, and that just cancels out. It cancels to 1. 2y divided by 2y is 1, not 0. So I have to put the plus 1 in there. And that should make sense, because when I go to distribute back to check, if I didn't have the 1 there, I wouldn't get that third term, right? So if you had 3 terms to start with, you need to have 3 terms in the parentheses. And now if I check that, 2y times 2y squared, 2 times 2 is 4, 1y plus 2 more is y to the third. 2 times 4 is 8, y times y would be y squared. You'd add the 1 and the 1 together. And 2y times 1 is 2y, and make sure that your signs are correct too. So that's your answer for that one. Okay, let's take a look at the third one that I had. Similar to the last one, we have to look for the common factor. I put a couple of different variables in there so you'd get a little more experience. Well, the common factor for the numbers 15, 25, and 10 is 5. So that's the greatest common factor. And then I'm also going to have to think about the x's. Well, when I look at the x's, I have 4, 3, and 5. The least amount I have anywhere is right here. I've got 3 x's here. So I'm going to need to take x to the third power out. I can't take any more than the smallest one. And then I'm going to look at the y's. I have 3, 1, and 4. So the smallest amount that I have is 1y. So that's what I'm going to take out, is 1y. Now I'm going to write what I'm dividing by, because the opposite of distributing, right? Because when we distribute, we multiply. When we factor, it's the reverse of that, which is actually then dividing. And I'm going to divide everything by 5x to the third y. Now, a lot of times when you see this, you'll be told that you want to make sure you have a lead term, which is your very first term, that's positive. So if you had a negative out front, you could take the negative out. Okay, 15 divided by 5, this is going to go inside the parentheses. That's 3. I have one extra x here, and I have two extra y's. Now I have a minus again. 25 divided by 5 is 5. No x's left and no y's left. It's just going to be minus 5. I'm having a hard time getting the lighting well just right today. Okay, and then 10 divided by 5 is 2. I have two additional x's, and I have three additional y's. So I go through and I divide each part, and when I'm dividing with powers of the same base, I'm just subtracting, right? 5 minus 3, 4 minus 1, that's the rules for exponents. If I wanted to check it, I could go back and multiply. 5 times 3 would be 15, 3 x's and 1 more x is 4, 1 y and 2 more y's is 3. My signs are correct. 5 times 5 is 25. I have x to the third and y. That's what's there. And then 5 times 2 is 10. I have 2 and 3, which is 5, and 1 and 3, which is 4. So that checks out to be correct. All right. Well, what happens when you want to take something out that looks like this? This has a common factor that's a binomial. Okay, so we want to take out the binomial out of that. So I'm going to write that binomial out front. Because I'm taking it out as a binomial, I'm putting parentheses around it. And what I'm dividing by is q plus 1. I'm dividing by it as a binomial. Okay, so you can see what happens. The q plus 1's go away, but you're left with 2p. And then the q plus 1's go away, and you're left with minus 7. So this one, these kind of tend to trip people up a little more because they feel like they want to write that q plus 1 twice. But what this actually looks like, if you think about multiplying it out, is you have q plus 1 times 2p. And then you have q plus 1 times minus 7. So it's actually right where we started with. By writing it out front, it applies to both of those. Okay, talk about this one then. What about this one? Well, we can see that, again, this has a common factor of 2c plus 4. And so I can take that out. So I'm going to write 2c plus 4. And then if I take that out, I'm saying divide by it. I say take it out. It really means divide. That's always what you're doing to each term. When you divide here, you can see you're left with 7a squared. What are you left with here? Well, again, just like when we saw 2y over 2y earlier, this cancels out to 1 because it's exactly itself, right? If you have the same thing top and bottom, you get 1. Or you can think about there's a 1 standing in front of that. We don't see it, but there's actually a 1 there. And so, again, we could just multiply that out. 7a squared times 2c plus 4, and then 1 times 2c plus 4, and get back to where we started. So sometimes people ask, like, what the heck? Factoring is such a weird thing. Factoring is actually something we do in English, right? We want to simplify things. So if you said, I have a family, John Smith plus Mary Smith. I know I'm using the most bland names, but I could introduce them that way. This is John Smith, and this is what Mary Smith. But I could say these are the Smiths, and I would just put Smith out front, And then I'd say John plus Mary. So what I want you to see with in English, we do that because it's instead of having to say the same thing every time, we can just say it once. This is what they have in common, their last name, and this is what they have that's different, their first names. For two people, it doesn't really matter, but what if you had a family of 12 people and it's like, you know, you're saying the last name 12 times? No way. You'd say these are the whatever their last names are, and then here's all the people that are in that family. So we use factoring in English to be more efficient. One bonus that I have here, because I had thought about it, when you're taking out a common factor, it could be that you take out a number, a variable, and a binomial all at the same time. So if you look at this, we have a common factor of 3 for the numbers. For the m's, we have an m that we can take out, and we can take out the n. And we can take out the 5x plus 3. So there's a lot of different things that they have in common. If I take out 3mn, 5x plus 3 out of each one, what happens here? Well, I have 2m. That's all that's left, right? The n's go, the 5x plus 3 goes. And over here, I took everything, so I have minus 1. So that is a, you know, we can take out that factoring issue. We can take that out that way, I mean. Okay, have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.